For nearly 2 years, I've provided for the monthly newsletter Health Justice of Boston. I've witnessed the growing inequality in healthcare in Massachusetts, so I strongly support Budget for All resolutions being considered here today. For many years now, we've witnessed the execution of a neocon agenda of regime change with its concomitant catastrophic spread of suffering and death. While the costs of this to us have skyrocketed, the survival of our healthcare infrastructure has been left to the vagaries of the marketplace. The neoliberal impulse to deregulate and privatize has led us to an extreme divergence between the haves and the have-nots. Some of the most profitable enterprises in this state and in this country are in healthcare and exist side by side with needed facilities and services teetering on the edge. Under this marketplace paradigm, attempts at healthcare reform have so far entrenched and exalted the role played by such unnecessary entities as commercial health insurance, the drug companies, and other profiteers. While our excellent public national health system and the people it served suffered 12 years of embargo and then the devastation of preemptive invasion and occupation, our bipartisan Massachusetts leadership deregulated hospital finance. The Democratic leader of this push quipped at the time that he would put all the scorpions in one bottle to see who would survive. That is, the marketplace would thin out the number of Boston teaching hospitals with their higher costs. What the healthcare marketplace has brought us instead is the loss of scores of community hospitals with such services as emergency departments, pediatrics, etc. All the scorpions, so-called, have survived, albeit transformed somewhat. Roxbury Comprehensive Community Health Center was allowed to fail in the spring of 2013, with one official quipping at the time that Boston had 22 such centers, so it wasn't such a big deal. It was a big deal for those in that central Roxbury neighborhood. North Adams Regional Hospital was allowed to succumb to the financial malfeasance of its CEO and board in March 2014. Leaving an impoverished Northern Berkshire County drastically underserved. Quincy Medical Center fell to this irrational system last December, significantly reducing the region's surge capacity. In case of disaster or epidemic and harming Quincy's elderly and diverse population, a similar fate is now in store for Lynn, I'm afraid. Communities of color and other working class communities are the first to suffer under this regime of marketplace medicine. To maintain services deemed necessary to fund the transition to a more economic and efficient single payer financing mechanism to begin the building. I'll submit my written report.
Appreciate it.
And thank you very much for
your time. Thank you for being here. Thank you for the
information.
Is there any members of the committee? Question?
Thank you.
Seeing none, thank you.